Lightweight. Attractive design. Quick power. User-friendly interface. Safety features. Android Auto and CarPlay. Phone mirror. If you are looking for a high-quality but low-cost MP5 2-DIN player for your vehicle, this is the one you must have. This player is made as user-friendly interface, lightweight, safety features, and the special thing is this is supported Android Auto as well as CarPlay. You can mirror Android phone or an Apple iPhone. Do not worry, there is no complicated connection steps, you just plug and play. Without more talking, let's check this unit. Stay with SetNFix. I ordered this from AliExpress recently. I think it is an opportunity you to see the details before purchasing this item. Shall we open the box to check the items inside? You can see there are wire connectors and rear camera as well. This is the audio wire harness, you have to connect this with car speakers. And this is the power cable. I will explain each wire one by one later. This is the multifunction IR remote controller. You can use this to operate the device. Now you can see the user manual, as I always say, read the user manual before starting the installation. There are more details regarding ring and other specifications. In this package, you are given the reverse camera as well. This is not with IR bulbs, but I think the white LEDs are enough for night. I will explain how to connect reverse camera with this device. You are given screws and double tape as well to connect the camera. And also instructions to connect the camera. Okay. This is the main part. This is the MP5 player with 7-inch display and suitable for 175mm width and 105mm height 2-DIN car head unit. When I take it to my hand, I felt like nothing on my hand. The unit is very light. These are the parts found in this MP5 player package. Now we can move towards the MP5 player. If you check the rear side, you can see the power interface. In this power interface, the power cable and the audio cable ports are there. You can connect the power cable here and the audio cable here. This is the main fuse. You can remove the fuse like this at the replacement. Use 10 ampere fuse to replace. This is 3.5 mm AUX input. You can give audio signals to the device using this port. You can see here more connectors. This is left side audio output, this is right side audio output. You can connect this unit with a power amplifier using these connectors. These yellow color connectors are for video outputs. If you want to connect extra displays to your vehicle, or if you want to install headrest monitors, you can use these connectors. I have done a video about how to connect headrest monitor to your car. You can see the link above. This is for video inputs. You can use this to connect a video input such as front camera, video player. And this is the backup camera connector. When the car gear changed to reverse, this connector will be activated. Therefore, you must connect reverse camera to this port. I will explain the way to connect it later. This is the FM antenna connector. You can connect the car aerial using this connector. Those are the connectors on the rear side. I will explain about front side after power on the device. I showed you that there are two power cables, one is for power and the other one is for audio. Now, let's check in details. In the power cable, this red color wire is to ignition wire of the car. This black wire is to ground connection. You have to connect his yellow wire with directly to the battery. This is the wire case to keep memory of the MP5 player. This is to be connected with parking light. The device will control brightness when you light on. This wire is to steering wheel switchers. I have done a separate video about DIY car steering wheel key. You can watch the video using the above link. This pink wire should be connected with reverse light, I will show it later. This is to brake light. This will also be used as a safety feature. You will see it later. Those are the wires in the power cable. This audio cable has 8 wires. You have to connect these two with front left side speaker, and this is front right side speakers. Accordingly, you can connect these two wires with rear left side speakers and these are with rear right side speakers. Now shall we power on this device? In order to power on the device, you have to connect both battery and ignition wire together. But when you install it to the car, you must connect battery wire with the battery and the ignition wire to the car ignition wire. Now connect black wire to the ground. Since the car players must power on with the car key on, this will automatically power on once the power is given. You can see how quick is it. The device has colorful lights. When you see the front panel, this hole is the mic, and this is the IR remote detector. You can see this button to go for previous such as radio channel, music. You can use this button as selection switch as well as a power switch. When you press the switch, you can change the mode like AUX, Bluetooth and radio. If you do long press, it will be the power switch. And, this button is front forward button. This rotary switch is doing multi-works. It is normally a volume controller. But you can select various options by pressing the button. You can adjust bass, adjust tribal, adjust balance and adjust FAD, adjust equalizer, adjust loud and not only that but also, brightness adjustment, contrast adjustment, saturation adjustment and hue adjustments as well. Next to the rotary switch, you can see, TF card port, reset switch and the USB port. I will show you now, how to connect rear camera. This package is included a reverse camera, extension cable and the power cable to the camera. Now we can connect those together. First shall we take the rear camera, then, connect the yellow connector with video extension cable. Now connect the power cable to the camera. This is the ground wire and this is the positive wire. You may not need to connect ground wire sometimes. Connect the red wire of the extension cable with the camera power cable. When you install it with then you have to connect these both with the car reverse bulb wire. Now connect the other end of the video extension cable to the camera connector of the MP5 player. Then, the red wire of the extension cable of that side must be connected with the pink wire of the main power harness. When you change the gear to reverse, the camera on with the power of reverse bulb. You can see the camera quality is also good. If you connect a USB drive with audio or video files, those files will automatically play. But, if it is a video, the main display will not show the videos as a safety feature. If you want to see the videos, you have to have activate the hand brakes. Shall we see what are there under the settings? Under the settings, you there are general, time, language, wallpaper and steering wheel key settings there. If you go to the general settings, you can see radio settings, screen saver on, off settings, video output settings, parking settings, backlight settings, Android settings, Apple settings, set left and right, logo settings, brightness settings, VCOM settings, and get phone book automatically option as well. If you want to change the light colors, you can select the specific color from backlight settings, or you can keep as auto to change the color frequently. Under the logo settings, you can change the boot logo from the given logos. The password is 1234. Under the time settings, you can change the time and the clock will run until the battery is connected. If you want to change the language, you can do in under the language settings. This wallpaper settings is to change the wallpapers, but there is only 2 wallpapers. Finally, you can set the steering wheel keys, using steer settings. The settings part is not much complicated. Even though this is a budget MP5 player, there is an option to connect Android and Apple phone. When you connect your iPhone, you can use the CarPlay. The important thing is the CarPlay connection speed and there is no much delay to detect. If you want to mirror the iPhone, that is also possible to do. But you cannot control the iPhone through MP5 player. You can only see the things in the iPhone. CarPlay is for Apple but Android phone has Android Auto. I will show how to mirror Android phone as well as how it is connected with Android Auto as well. Mirror connection is not like CarPlay. When the Android phone is connected, you can operate Android phone using MP5 player as well as from the phone. When connecting Android Auto also has no complicated steps. When the Android Auto is selected, the device connects with the Android phone. This IR remote controller can be used to operate MP5 player. All the options are available in this remote controller. Finally, if you are looking for a low cost but more features, I can recommend this to use for your vehicle. Considering all the things, the only weak point is this display. When you touch it, you cannot feel it like touching but pressing. However, you can choose your MP5 player as suitable for your budget. Special thing is, you can use CarPlay in Android Auto and also mirroring both Android and Apple phones. This is SetNFix, and do not forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. I will come with another new video. Until then, be innovative. Stay with SetNFix.